What is up, everyone? Back again to deliver some more Star Wars goodness on the SNES here. This time with Super Empire Strikes Back. Now, this is by far the hardest game I've ever beat to date. This was way worse than Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles or Ninja Gaiden. And to quote the angry video game nerd, it's as hard as a T-Rex's shit. This video also marks the first time I ever legitimately beat this game, start to finish in one sitting with no passwords or codes. So I must say, this is a big accomplishment for me as a gamer. I played it through on easy because this game is absolutely fucked on any other difficulty. So once again, the opening crawl is just like the movie. These games remind me of, like when you're a kid and you buy Star Wars storybooks. It seems like how they sum up the story. This is my favorite Star Wars movie out of all three. I don't count the prequels because they don't exist to me. So because this was my favorite Star Wars movie, I always wanted to, you know, do a playthrough of this game. But this also coincidentally happens to be the hardest out of all of them, so made for quite a challenge. Watched any of these cutscenes before this playthrough either. They're much better than in the first one. Alright, here we go. So basically in this first stage here, I'm going to be collecting a lot of blaster power-ups. Because your gun is absolutely worthless without them. You'll see later on in the game why that is. Oh, the Tauntaun. There's a lot of vehicle riding in this game. Immediately gonna switch to the blaster because the lightsaber kinda sucks in this game. I don't know if maybe because you start with the lightsaber they decided to nerf it a little bit from the last game, but it doesn't seem to be as good. At the end of this Tauntaun stage, I should have almost 100% powered up blaster, and then I just need one more icon from the cave. Platforming in this game is much worse than in Super Star Wars. The enemies are way more trolly. Comes to pushing you off the platforms. Those ice shards that come up out of the ground are fucking awful. They just cause so much damage. Now I'm trying to, like, get caught in this stupid lift that takes me up. I don't know why they incorporated that. That's kind of weird. So now my blaster's powered up full, which enables me to take out these wampas very easily. Fuck. Fucking bats. These bats never stop coming either. I don't have any of the paths or anything really memorized all that well, so you're gonna see me take some wrong turns here. See how much damage those things do? Fuck. So I'm just trying to be fancy and jump up on that platform from the one right under it, but I can't do it. I'm not too terribly worried about health, because I'm gonna get some health right here, and the boss isn't actually that hard. I believe this boss is called the Mutant Wampa. I could be wrong about that. That. Easy enough. Back in the saddle again. Porcupines are an interesting enemy choice for this level. Some more cave bullshit. So Hoth is the longest section of the game. You spend about half, maybe a little bit more than half of the game just on Hoth alone. Like fuck that. The lift just takes me up and captures me on a spike. Super Empire for you. That Wampa was on a mission. Once again, I can't seem to get on this platform. That's it for the caves. Whee! Thank you. know this is the hardest. This might actually be my favorite of the Super Star Wars games. It might be because I just like Empire so much, and by extension, I'm just going to choose this, but it's still pretty fun. So now we got kind of a mini boss here. He won't take any damage unless you take out his arms first. Coming up to the actual boss here. If you don't have a powered up blaster for this, it's just using the lightsaber, because it's your best choice in that instance. Take a quick run through Rebel Base here. This kind of foreshadows the levels we'll be doing with Han Solo later on. So you want to kill that thing, because if not, it'll follow you through this whole section. It'll just rubber band your vehicle speeder here and just shoot at you the whole time. There's really no strategy here, as you can see. So, Mode 7 sucks giant donkey dick, and I fucking hate it. I don't particularly find any of the Mode 7 levels in the Super Star Wars games to be particularly fun. However, I will say though, this is pretty inventive gameplay for the time. Definitely raised the bar for what was capable for the SNES. They pretty much remade this entire level in Shadows of the Empire for the N64 and did a much better job. Now, one of the things that makes this hard for me, Mode 7 levels, is that the controls are inverted, and like I don't know how to play with inverted controls anymore. It just feels so foreign and weird. Can't get used to it. to do a let's play of Shadows of the Empire at some point, but the again, the inverted control is kind of making my gameplay extremely sloppy. Not that my gameplay is perfect anyways, but I mean, it's just, it's extra sloppy. So yeah, you want to try and avoid running into shit, because it'll just fuck you right up. Try and take my time during this level, it's just a few wrong moves and pretty much dead, as you will see later on. Until Rogue One. I'm super excited. It's also very close to the premiere of Season 3 of Rebels, which I'm really looking forward to. I like Season 2 a lot. I can't wait to see what they do with that. Actually shoot down the AT-ATs. They take damage, but I'm sure it's possible. So the control for shooting the tow cables at the AT-AT can be kind of weird at first, but you'll get used to it. The screen going dark like that makes it hard to actually see the tow cable. So I really don't want to die, because if I die I'm going to lose my blaster power-ups, and I really don't know where to find them in the rest of the game. So I'm pretty much fucked if I lose them. Always just hold down the fire button here, because you don't know if you're going to catch a stray speeder bike or not that's coming at you. Like I said, you don't want anything to run into you. That's it for Mode 7 for a little bit. Levels like this are basically just free points. Fucking jetpack, stormtroopers, almost like ninjas. These are way worse than jetpack ninjas and ninja guide these guys. Especially later on in the game, trying to platform Cloud City and these fucking jetpack stormtroopers are flying around all over the place.
Yes.
This level's pretty straightforward. You just run right, go up the elevator, go left, repeat. Alright, so here's the AT-AT boss. Now, what I like to do is try and farm maybe a thermal detonator if I'm lucky, or get some shields. I was lucky here and got a thermal. So you just run over and kill the boss in one hit. I'm continuing to shoot because the jetpack stormtroopers keep spawning even after the boss is defeated, and they will kill you if they can. You'll have to do it all over again. Alright, we get to play as Han Solo now. That's pretty awesome. So like I said earlier, I really don't have a lot of the paths in this game memorized, and this is one of those levels I get lost in. So one thing you'll see me do every now and then is just stand outside a door or something that has respawning enemies and just farm some hearts whenever I need to. Just like so. Yeah, I don't know what happened there. Just kind of mashing on the controller, I guess. Maybe I got that part confused with the next Rebel base.
Thank you.
So much lag. Start with the chopper boss. Really not sure what else you could call it. It's pretty easy. Unless, of course, your blaster is weak, then it's not. For days in this level. So it goes without saying, the music in this game is absolutely outstanding. It is John Williams' score, of course. So it happens to be my favorite, well, I guess it's tied favorite with Return of the Jedi for favorite Star Wars soundtrack. Jedi's got some epic shit on it. Pretty close to the boss. This was a boss that gave me a lot of trouble until I found out something that made it considerably easier. So if you just shoot at the air up here, you'll see that a shield appears, and then you can just run right in. Damage the thing that you need to take off before you can actually deliver actual damage to the boss. And it just dies. Pretty easy. This is the least shittiest Mode 7 level in this game. I don't know why, but for some reason you'll see me, like, moving the Falcon in a circular motion, and it helps you not take damage from the meteors and whatnot. I'm really not sure how that works. If I was to just stay in a static position and try and shoot the meteors, I would probably die. Which would be very embarrassing to die on this level. This is kind of a remake of the level that they had in the Star Wars NES. Pilot the Falcon through an asteroid field. Of course, there's no TIE fighters in the NES version. I believe you die in one hit in the NES version, unless you get the Falcon shield. This is one of those levels that seems to just go on forever and ever. Everybody's making a lot of noise upstairs. I usually record my commentary really late at night when everybody's sleeping, but I'm just gonna do it right in the middle of the day today. Glad that's finally over with. And we're also finally off Hoth. Get to see something different. So here's Dagobah. These levels are pretty short. Straight here, you just want to jump down from that platform and grab the force power elevation. This is extremely useful and essential for beating the game, in my opinion. I guess you don't really need it, but it sure helps a lot. So I keep falling through the environment right there. I have no idea why. Like, I don't understand. Get to use force elevate. Yeah, those things are invincible. I always get stuck on those things. I believe those things are gun darts. See how much damage like things like that do to you on easy. You can imagine what they do on Jedi. So this is kind of the worst out of the Dagobah stages, this one coming up. So you want to use elevate and get to the top of the stage right away, because you want to avoid spawning the water underneath, because then it turns into an auto-scroller, and you don't want that. Or at least I don't want that. So I'm just slashing randomly here, because I know there's force power-ups. So I'm using Elevate to get to this series of platforms over here that contain other force powers, and force power, like those green things that fill your force bar up. I don't use any of these force powers with the exception of heal. So now right here, there's supposed to be like something that comes up from underneath the water and it turns into an auto-scroller, but because I skipped the initiate for it, then it just doesn't happen. So up there, I just got a extra life and a health sword. Now I'm gonna switch to force heal and fight what I consider to be the shittiest boss in the game. I hate this thing. Like the ATSD, you have to damage and disable a certain part of it before you can damage the thing itself, but as you can see, there's five things that you have to attack. I'm pretty sure this boss has the highest vitality of anything in the game, including Darth Vader. There is a glitch using Force Elevate where you can drop into this boss from the very top of the level, and somehow if you do that, the boss will spawn, but all its like eyes and nose and shit won't be there, so you can just damage it right away. But I have no idea how to do this glitch. Yeah, if you try and do this with the blaster, it's just... you're just gonna die. So now I can finally damage this thing. You can see how much hits it takes. It's just absolutely ridiculous. I suppose if you switch to the blaster now and use that, though, it'd probably be beneficial. I always just stick with the lightsaber. Finally. Dagobah. Now we're on to the hardest part of the game. So these Cloud City platforms are absolutely fucking horrible. They wouldn't be so bad if they didn't, like, depress when you stood on them, like this one. Like, that's so annoying. These infinitely respawning guys can be useful for farming hearts. I reason why I do most of my commentaries late at night. So the platforming in this section is particularly annoying. Because whenever you go to jump over here, a guy comes out the door and just pushes you down. Who's the bounty hunter right there? I fucking hate that enemy. You'll see him troll me super bad later on. So you get to see how bullshit these fucking stormtroopers are. And those guys at the door. That went pretty smooth, actually. That never goes that good in any of my other... Never went in that good in any of my other playthroughs. Those crushy things really hurt. So we're coming up on the boss here. I really want to try and get a thermal detonator because it'll kill it in one hit, but not so lucky. If anyone knows what this thing is, feel free to let me know. I have no idea. Heading into what's called the Toy Factory with Chewie. This is one of two levels you get to play as Chewbacca. This level really kind of sucks with the amount of shit they throw at you. These purple balls, I fucking hate these things. Those purple balls are like the bane of my existence in this game. I hate them so much. They follow you around, they open randomly, and that lava that they drops just takes so much health away. It's like I'm trying to shoot it, but it won't open, and it just pushes me right into the lava. There goes half my health bar from one enemy. I that's the only time I use the spin. It's actually a really useful move, I don't utilize it very much. It's a much more useful move in Return of the Jedi. See how bad the lava damages you there. I should have waited for that platform, but just went for it anyway. So I'm pretty low on health. I'm right by the boss. I just went for it anyway. And hope that I could beat it without losing a life. It's not very tough. So it's got this three vents that you have to take out. And after you take those out, then the boss can be damaged. This is the carbonate chamber. Towards the end of this level is where everything starts to go bad. In this level. It's one of the things I really liked about Battlefront and the Bespin DLC when I played that. So the color in the level was so nice. Got these purple fuck faces back again. Shooting these vents so they don't freeze me. They shoot this blue smoke that freezes you. It's really annoying. So now I go from like a full health bar to just completely fucked. Because I keep trying to kill these fucking purple things, but they keep respawning anyway, so it doesn't really matter. If I had just ran right to the boss, I'd have been fine. This thing drops a lava thing and just kills me, pretty much. So there is a magic pixel that you can land on if you roll into this room, and you won't take any damage, but I fucked it up. So I received my first death. Now my gun sucks. I can't hit those crouching guys straight on anymore. I have to angle my gun down. I was really disappointed when I died there. I was kind of hoping that I'd get at least to the X-Wing level without losing a life. So you can see this thing's pretty much taking damage continuously, and its health bar is draining so slowly. It's like the level 1 gun just does no damage at all. It's just absurd. Thank you.